regarding your board examination, for whether it is for 10th or 12th and whether it is for 11th arts. Okay, and the main topic is figure of speech. Whether we can consider that, it is only consistent, obtain only 1 to 2 marks. But whenever you are doing any poetry section topic, in that case, that plays a very crucial and important role. And the main topic which we are discussing today, that is figure of speech. Okay, students, as you all know that firstly we must discuss what actually figure of speech is. I can just say that you have heard earlier also, and if we just say that if we translate into Hindi, that becomes alankar. Okay, as you all know that ki kisi bhi cheez ko agar hum show bhi hai agar ek sadharan si language mein hum kisi ko kehte hain ki you are looking very nice, so you are looking very nice, that is a simple line. But if I say that you are looking or you are blossoming like a rose, so that means you have added something to your sentence which give a very effective and a natural effect to the person whom you are telling that. This is called figure of speech. And whenever we are doing the poetry section and whenever we do the extract questions, obviously you are going to have the question related to that. And it is of many types, but today I am going to just relate you to the basic figure of speeches. Okay, first of all we are thinking about the simile. Okay, simile is just where we are used to say something to a comparison, like I am just telling it is a comparison between two things, two persons. Okay, and you can just identify it with you say like or like, as like. Okay, you are as beautiful as your mother, so that means you are being comparing to a person. Who is that person? That is your mother. Okay, and over here life is like a dream, and we are what I am saying that life kaisi hai, sapno ki jaisi hai, so we are comparison because life mein hum log ek aur hum log usme praise le lete hain, man proposes, god disposes. That means sometimes some men used to play something, predict something and happen something. So here life is compared with dreams. Sapne jo hai koi zaruri nahi ki wo hamesha sach ho. Okay, so here we are talking about dreams. Let's move to the second figure of speech, that is metaphor. As you have heard earlier also that we have done the simile and over there we were doing the comparison. And what was the comparison exactly like? The comparison where we used to use like, as like and like. Over there, when you do a direct comparison, this simply converts into metaphor. Are you getting me, sir? कि अगर आप इस comparison को अगर as like और उसके जैसा बताते हैं तो वो simply है, लेकिन बिल्कुल direct connection देते हैं तो वो क्या बन जाता है बच्चे? Metaphor. For example, life is not a bed of roses. Over here, there actually figure of speech है क्या? जो line हमें कही जाती है उसका direct sense नहीं होता, उसका direct abstract नहीं होता, उसका कुछ और relate करता है. Okay बेटा? Okay. जैसे life is not a bed of roses. That means life is not that smooth as we all used to think. Okay. Now let's move to the third one. That is personification. As you have heard, the word personification, that means it is related to person. Okay, when any non-living thing is compared to be a living, that is called personification. What we call it as manviya karan alankar. Okay, lifeless objects or abstract. What do you mean by abstract? Abstract is the feeling. It is a sense. Okay, and ideas haven't life. And if you consider these figure of speech. Whenever you are talking about sounds, then obviously you are talking about monophony. Okay? Now let's move towards another figure of speech, that is hyperbole. As you all know that hyperbole means hyper. Assuming something, assuming something, जो है नहीं उसे बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ा चढ़ा के कहना. जैसे हिंदी में आप जैसे अतिशोक्ति अलंकार कहते हैं. जैसे एग्जाम्पल के तौर में, जैसे राणा ने सोचा इस पार जब तक चेतन था उस पार. We are talking about extreme exclamations to show emphasis. View को show किया जाता है बहुत बढ़ा चढ़ा के. जैसे example, she wept ocean of tears. Okay? That means कि क्या हम assume कर सकते हैं कि हमने पूरे आंसुओं से समुद्र भर दिया. इस तरह की जो assumptions होती हैं, इनको हम लोग किसके अंदर लेते हैं बेटा? Oceans of the in hyperbole, assuming for the higher peaks. Okay? Now we are talking about anti. Anti means except, means opposite. Okay? And over here it is antithesis. It is just like the oxymoron. We talk about the oxymoron in which we talk about the opposite meaning. Over here also, but it is contrasting. Okay? There we totally talk about the opposite one, which over here we are talking about contrasting, like united we stand. That means when you unite or when we divide. So here is a contrast. If you unite, you are going to stand. So here is a contrasting one. And if you stand, unite, you are going to stand. And if you are going to divide, you are going to fall. So this type of sentences are called as antitheses in figure of speech. Let's move to the next one. That is alliteration. And that too is very, very easy. This we call in Hindi as anuprasarika. Okay? In that, it is a repetition of consonant sounds. You would have heard about there are 26 alphabets. Okay? In English. And when we are talking about the vowels, so we are having A, E, I, O, U. That means we are going to have 5 vowels. So over here, after converting, leaving the vowels, we are going to have the consonant sounds. And over here, alliteration means when one word is repeated continuously, so we call as alliteration. Over here, how happy he is here. So over H, 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 and H. Okay, students, let's move to one more. That is associates. Vowel sound repeats. Over here, we were talking about the consonant sounds. But when we move from alliteration to associates, here we are talking about the vowel sounds, that means A, E, I, O, U. Okay? So over here, men sell the wedding bells. So over here, you see that there is a repetition of vowel E over here. Now let's move to another one. That is fun, but we call it as Sleeshalinka. Okay? One word gives a different meaning. Each word has different meanings to show. Over here, like in our 12th standard, there is a poem Keeping Quiet written by Pablo Neruda. And in that poem, Pablo Neruda says that we should not move our arms too much. So over here, here is a word arms which gives two different meaning. Arms is the body parts, okay? That is the body part. And if we talk about another, that is weapon. Another one is weapon, जो हम लोग शस्त्रों का इस्तेमाल करते हैं battles में. That is over here, when one word give two different meanings, so that is known as fight. Okay, let's move to the another and very interesting word, that is imaginary. When you imagine something, okay, that means when you are sitting in your room and imagine that you are in a very, very beautiful segment over there where the lakes are chirping of the birds and so many things are going on. Over here, associated with mental picture. You imagine something in your mind. Okay? So that is what imaginary. The stone fell with a splash in the lake. When you heard something, when you are just something you are assuming in yourself and you just feel that you are in that position, that is called imaginary. Over here, when you say something that, dear, I am just in the dark and there is a very cold breeze going on and you assume men may go, men may come. It is a line from the poem Brook. And a set of words it can be, or a group of lines also. That means combination of two or three lines. And appear to at the end of the poem. Okay, student, this was the topic which we have done today related to figure of speech. And in the next video, I am going to relate with other literary devices. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Thank you.